Sirikit.
And I am Tai. In this video, we are going to talk about the feasibility of solar roofs, which is a potential solar roof of the future.
So what are solar roofs? They're roof surfaces layered with solar panels that generate electricity and feed it to the grid. Can you imagine if the road right outside your house could generate enough electricity to power your entire neighborhood? Well, guess what? It's already a reality in some countries. Countries such as France, Netherlands, and the USA already have a working prototype of solar roads. The main problem with solar energy generation is that it requires a lot of area. But think about it. What else covers a lot of area and gets plenty of sun? Roads! Wouldn't it be great if we could generate electricity from the roads while simultaneously reducing the greenhouse effect? Let's have a look at the solar road in Kromene in North Holland, Netherlands, a country full of cycling and clean energy enthusiasts with 17 million people and 18 million bicycles have constructed a solar bike path. It was developed by a consortium consisting of the province of North Holland, TNO, an organization for applied scientific research, Civil, a construction company, and ImTech, a technical service provider. The 70-meter bicycle path consists of solar panels that are sandwiched between glass, silicon rubber, and concrete. The top layer is a 1 centimeter thick translucent tempered glass. It lets in sunlight, repels dirt, and is skid resistant. Underneath this layer lies the crystalline silicon solar cells. The panels work individually and are all connected to the smart meter, which optimizes their output. It also channels the electricity produced into the grid or powers the road's lighting, traffic signals, and signage. In its first 6 months, Solar Road generated 3,000 kilowatt hours, which is enough to power up a single person household for a year. But as you can see in the graph, the energy production of the road gradually increased and exceeded the expectations of its makers. The output in the first 6 months translates to an annual yield of more than 70 kilowatt hours per square kilometer per year, while lab tests showed 50 kilowatt hours to be the average annual yield. By the end of its first year, the bike path generated 9,800 kilowatt hours of electricity, enough to power 3 households for a year. The construction of the solar road cost an estimated $3.7 million, which seems like an expensive way to generate a small amount of electricity. However, most of this cost seems to have gone into R&D for the prototype, and so the next solar bike path shouldn't cost as much. The road has an estimated lifespan of 20 years, but has an expected payback period of 15 years, after which there will be a return on investment. So let's crunch some numbers. Solar costs merely $2 per watt in the Netherlands. The initial investment of $3.7 million could have bought 1.8 megawatts of solar, which in a 6 month period could have generated 520,000 kilowatt hours of electricity. With that much electricity, 173 houses could have been powered instead of one. Similarly, if an equivalent area of solar panels were installed on rooftops, it could have generated 4,600 kilowatt hours in a 6 month period. That is 50% higher than what the solar bike path generates in the same time. Critics also point out that a flat solar panel reduces the efficiency by 30%. While solar roof panels have a typical efficiency of 10 to 20%, the solar bike path only has an efficiency of 8.6%. This is also perhaps because of the cyclists that cast a shadow on the panels. However, the developers believe that the large surface area will make up for the difference. Another interesting byproduct of a future with solar roads is the inevitable rise of the electric vehicles. Once solar roads prove to be a viable source of uniform electricity generation, the makers plan to introduce inductive power transfer, IPT charging, through the roads. IPT is a contactless power transfer system. Researchers calculated the prospects of an IPT system for the solar bike path, and they found that with an estimated energy yield of 10,000 kilowatt hours per year, the solar bike path could charge 25,675 e-bikes in a single year. As a proof of concept, the results are reassuring. The bike path can withstand the weight and the weather, and it is generating electricity. So what seems to be the problem? The high price tag and the current limitations of the project. But does that mean this idea should be completely discarded? Absolutely not. Renewable energy projects like these pave the way to further discussion and more such projects that intend to build a greener future. The success of this prototype shows that there is a future in building infrastructure that promotes a more sustainable society.
Let's move on to the US solar roadways project. You might have watched the viral video Solar Freaking Roadways, which has 22 million views on YouTube. Thousands of people donated an amount of over $2 million to its fundraising campaign, because they believe this will be the road of the future. Not just that, the US Department of Transportation has so far provided $1.6 million as funding for the project. The solar roadways doesn't just intend to generate electricity through the solar panels on the road. They plan to make a positive environmental impact and transform the current transportation system. It has a special solar panel that claims many exciting features, such as providing LED lights to signal the driver and can be used to display road lights instead of paint. Solar roadways panels can also melt snow and ice during the winter and have visibility during daytime. This is quite a big business because slippery roads and low visibility during winter cost an estimated amount of $3.7 billion to the US each year. The panels also claim to have motion detection to protect animals and can alert the drivers if there are any accidents ahead. Let's look at the design of this special solar panel to see how it's gonna do all of those. This SR solar panel has a hexagonal design with three layers. The top layer is made of iron float glass. It can withstand various weather conditions, hot, cold, rain, and snow. It also provides strength for vehicles to drive on, and it has an internal heating system in order to melt snow and ice. Last but not least, it is transparent so the sunlight can pass through for the solar cell right under to generate electricity. The middle layer contains electronic elements, microprocessor, circuits, cables, and interconnection to control the expected functions. Finally, the bottom layer is used for supporting entire structure resting upon the ground surface. Recycled glass form 10% of the base, and the internal support structures are made of recycled plastic. The SR panels have an efficiency of 18.5%. If the panel is installed in each and every road surface in America, including parking lots, driveways, playground, which spans a total area of about 33,000 square miles, it will generate 3 times the total US electricity usage. But let's talk about money. If solar roadways become a reality for entire US, it will generate 14 billion kilowatt hours of electricity per year. So, if the electricity price is 10 cents per kilowatt hour, it must $1.4 billion per year. To install the solar panel everywhere in the US, it would cost $56 trillion. So, 56 trillion divided by 1.4 billion that the road gives us every year. This means we need 40,000 years to pay back for the initial cost. However, the amazing solar panel is only expected to operate for 30 years. The future of this road looks ridiculously impossible for the current price of this technology. It's worth mentioning that this calculation do not take into account the multitude of other functionalities that the solar roadway makers promise. Snow melting, making road painting obsolete, animal protection, electric vehicle charging, and so much more. On top of that, it would be reducing our dependency on fossil fuels and consequently reduce the greenhouse effect. These innovative ventures into clean and sustainable energy generation are only trying to make the world a better place. But is it the solution to go with at the moment? If money was not an issue, it would be a great idea. But money is a big issue, and so the people who are dreaming about harnessing power through solar roads might have to put their dreams to wait for the moment. So what could be the solution to energy generation and the current state of transportation?
Well, Elon Musk's Hyperloop is one such example that combines solar energy and transportation. Hyperloop is a high-speed transportation system that uses the concept of pneumatic tubes. A pod-like vehicle is propelled inside a vacuum tube at high speeds using linear accelerators. Designed to be 4.25 meter wide and 563 kilometer long, the solar panels on top of the Hyperloop could generate 285 megawatts during peak solar activity. The solar arrays are expected to cost $210 million. Another innovation that combines solar power and transportation is solar panel-covered shaded structure in South Korea. The structure is a bike path running through the middle of the highway from Daejeon to Sejong City. It provides shade to the cyclists while simultaneously generating clean energy. The 400 solar panels lying on top of the structure generate 6,000 kilowatt hours of electricity per day. That is equivalent to the amount of energy powering 600 households per day. With the growth of solar energy industry, many innovative ideas of solar energy generation will be created. Some ideas are cost-effective and efficient, some are not. Nonetheless, all ideas lead to advances in solar technology, which will consequently lower our dependency on non-renewable resources and mark a complete shift to clean and sustainable energy generation.